I don't even know why that's a thought process in your brain. Women leave every fucking day for less money. For less money.
Why is it taking me a fucking year and 3 months to fucking figure out that I'm scared of her?
I don't know, man. I know that you gotta choose.
Because you're fearful that the marriage is gonna be ended. You gotta release it. Release it.
What I mean is, I don't know, because I think it's all a matter of choice. It's literally choice. The day you have your aha moment and realize, well, I'm not a coward. I've been acting pretty fucking stupid. I'm not following my program. I'm not listening to my Lord's advice. I'm not listening to Cass. I'm kind of doing it my old way, and that didn't work for me for years. I wouldn't go with coward. I'd go with fucking stupid. And call yourself. I love what he said. Call yourself out and call yourself up. Up. That's what we do here. We rise up. Now, it's okay. I don't want you to feel bad. That, you know, this is part of the not babying the nice guy and loving that little boy. I don't want you to feel bad. But that's what we do. If you own the fact that you're a victim, if you own the fact that you're stupid, if you own the fact that you are afraid, then you can choose what you want and do what that guy would do. I don't want to be afraid of my wife. That sounds stupid. That sounds bitchy. That sounds like a baby. I just want to be a man. Listen, I'm going to talk about the kids tomorrow. I'm off to bed. Oh, you're a fucking coward. I can appreciate why you might think that. I guess you do. Yeah. I'm actually tired. Good night, babe. Love you. Well, fucking tell me you love me. What? Kicks you in the balls. Close one. God, you're fun and feisty. All right. Good night, babe. I'm tired. Like, fuck, man. What feels better? Letting her get under your skin? Or being the boss of you. Lord.
Yeah.
Why is it taking so long? Because you have to choose, man. You have to choose. You know, hands down, you're not manipulating, but you're choosing to feel bad because she thinks you're manipulating. That's it. Because if you're not manipulating, there's nothing to feel bad for. That's you letting your nice guy win. Oh, no, she doesn't approve.
When she says, hey, you're manipulating this, that, and the other, it's like, well, I can see why you think that.
I wouldn't even, for that one, I wouldn't even say that anymore. I'd be like, well, that's just not true. Would you like to hear what's going on? See, I smiled and I leaned in? Because I'm not a fucking afraid. Once you guys practice this, it becomes natural. Right? It just becomes natural. When you choose and you do what you want to support that choice, it becomes a part of who you are. Right? Well, that's not true. Would you like to hear? I'm gonna tell you what's going on. Fucking smile, lean in. Curious face with the hands. There's a statue with the curious man. Like, how do you make this shit up, guys? You just gotta break away from who you are and be who you want to be. Because it has been with you since you were a kid. And there's so many of you. And guys, this isn't just your wife. This is your coping mechanisms. This is your, I'd rather sleep instead of getting up at 4:30 with Cass today. This is every part of your life. I'd rather sit on the couch because, man, I had a long day. This is why we don't succeed. You know, for a long time.
This is the only part of the life that I don't step up in. I've been this company 7 months. Of course, I'm leaving the department. At 5 o'clock in the morning, a daughter gets up with me at 5 in the morning. I'm leading her and working out and nutrition.
Jeff, that's all wonderful. And if you didn't let your wife get under your skin, she might have a chance to stop and reflect. I'm not even worried about her falling right now. I want her focused on reflecting because she's doing some pretty wrong things. Sounds like for a long time. In order for her to want to follow, she's going to have to want to reflect. And those kind of start depending on who she is at different times. But none of that happens if you're not in a position to be worthy of leadership. Meaning, you know, and here's one for all the wives that are listening on lives right now, you know, like, I don't need a leader, blah, blah, blah. Well, listen, your wife needs a leader. She's fucking gaslighting you and being saying mean shit, not involved with the family, absolutely ruining the mood, buzzkill every single day. Yep, she needs a fucking leader. So go be a leader. What do you want? Do that. That's it. It does seem hard. It seems impossibly hard. That's because you've been told day in and day out, Narcissists can't change. You probably wonder if she's a narcissist every single day. It's because you've been told day in and day out, it takes two. That's because of those kinds of things that you think it's impossible unless she wants to change and she wants to reflect and grow. Otherwise, no, man. It takes one to lead. One. And then that leader makes a choice if she doesn't want to follow. Guys, forget marriage for a second. Pretend you're leading a company, you're CEO. You start taking responsibility for yourself when your employees fuck up. You start trying to do everything differently, make a new plan for the next quarter, for the next year. You're not blaming your employees, you're blaming yourself. Those CEOs win. And if the people have been enabled for a long time, they don't like the extra hours and the way we're doing our core values and the plan and all the structure we're putting in place, you fire them and you get new people. It's choice. Leaders have choice.
What are you doing with that? We're not like that.
That's why your wife chooses to sleep in the basement and chooses to yell at you all the time. Because she's the leader.
I'm trying.
Okay?
And she's only here right now because she can't afford to leave.
Jeff, I don't even know why that's a thought process in your brain. Women leave every fucking day for less money. For less money. I just talked to my dad's wife. Remember I told you guys I'm just connecting with my dad's wife again about a year ago? We've talked 3 or 4 times on the phone in a year. She still hasn't gone for the money yet. Multi-millionaire. Multi-millionaire. I don't know how many, what, 40, 60 million he probably sold his insurance brokerage for? Sold it. She didn't take the money yet. She just wanted out. Stop fucking babying yourself with stupid shit like, oh, she can't leave. You don't know her. You don't deep down know her. In fact, I know that because you can't even have a conversation with her. So fucking stop telling me you know what your wife is doing. Stop wasting your thought process on stuff like that. Stop.
Spinning my wheels for no fucking reason.
Yeah, man. 100%. 100%. If a woman could take millions and didn't yet, stop worrying about dollars.